now joined by FS1 NBA analyst Eddie House. So when you hear all of these quotes, yes, they're anonymous, but what is your reaction to these words?
I don't have a reaction to it. Everybody has something to say. First off, good morning. Let me say that to you guys first. Good morning. But everybody has something to say. He kind of just rocked a boat going to L.A. It makes everybody, I think it makes people in the Western
Conference. Might have unrocked.
No, I think what's really happening, people in the Western Conference are getting uncomfortable.
Oh, come on.
I'm telling you, they're getting uncomfortable. But you put the best player in the world in the Western Conference, Portland's going to move down.
You really think so?
You
did
think
they
Portland,
get worse in the offseason?
Did they get better?
Well, they finished third last year.
I know the Lakers got a whole lot better. You added Rondo, one of the highest IQ basketball players out there. You add LeBron James, the best basketball player on the planet. Lance Stephenson, who gets under LeBron's skin, who's a good defense. JaVale McGee, I mean, okay, he's a rebounder, shot blocker. Do your job, stay in your lane. But you have toughness from that team. I think they're better than Portland. I think they'll be better than Utah. They'll be better than your Spurs. They'll be better than the Pelicans.
Have you turned into a Laker fan?
No, I used to be when I was young. Showtime Lakers, I was a Laker fan. When once Magic retired, I just started liking players. But no, I'm not a Laker fan.
Relive your childhood.
No, I can't. I'm a Celtic. I'm a Celtic. I'm just keeping it 100 right now.
I think you're keeping it about 60.
No, all the way 100. 1,000.
What I can't understand is that we've never seen a guy, because when he was in the East, he didn't want to compete. And then when he wanted to compete, he went to a ready-made team. He joined links. He linked up with Bosch and Wade, and then he wanted to dominate. Now he goes to the West, which is the tougher of the two conferences. He didn't join a super team. Everybody says super teams are ruining it. Look at Golden State. They get Boogie Cousins. You look at the Celtics and what they've been able to do. So if he'd gone to the Celtics, that would have been a problem. He wanted a ready-made team. He goes to Philly. He just wants more superstars. He goes to the West. He joined the Lakers, and now that's a problem. Now he doesn't want to win. A guy that's won his entire career, wants the challenge, takes on the challenge. He didn't go, Paul George, first of all, Paul George has nothing. LeBron is a lion. Paul George doing what Paul George did, didn't even move the needle.
He's a lamb? Is that what you're saying?
No. He might be he's a little predator. I mean, he gets some, but he ain't lying to King of the
Ah, okay.
Yeah, on the Savannah.
You realize LeBron. Paul George had a chance to come west, and he said, no, I'm staying right here in OKC. It's okay with me.
You do realize.
I don't want to play with LeBron James.
Paul George had a chance to beat LeBron, too, on several occasions.
He
and when did that ever happen?
Yeah.
Never, ever, ever. And that's
Paul
never
going George didn't have enough help.
I know for a fact he didn't say, I don't want to play with LeBron James. That's who you want to play with. That's who you want to play with. He's going to get you the basketball.
Paul George, who could have come home to at least the L.A. area, Palmdale. It's about,
he didn't want that pressure.
He stayed with his partner, man.
That's all it was. He didn't want that pressure.
His boy, that year with Russ, they came together, they clicked, and he liked it over there. He feel like he ain't got unfinished business.
So now I'm up against LaEddie and LaShane. You've sold out, too. LaEddie. So all these quotes are exactly what I said within hours after the bombshell first dropped, and LeBron's coming to L.A., he's not coming to the Lakers. He's just coming to Los Angeles. It's sunshine. It's Hollywood. It is the staple stage because it's the second biggest city in the country. It's West Coast. LeBron needed a year off. He came to the Western Conference with no ideas about, there's no premeditation about, I have to have a second star, a third star. I thought there was going to be contingency plan A, B, and C. There are none. He did not get Paul George. He did not get Kawhi Leonard. He got nobody. He's going to be a solo star with a bunch of young players on the verge of becoming good players, but they're still raw and green, and a bunch of veteran players who are incredibly difficult to coach. There are four guys on that team that Luke Walton's going to have issues with if he doesn't get them their minutes. It's become the most difficult team to coach in basketball. It's not even close. So now you got that against a Western Conference, and I love this quote from a prominent agent. I think I know who it was, but he said, playing in the Western Conference, night in, night out, is not the same. You don't get a night off. And he said, I would not want to end my career just making the playoffs. That's all you can do. You're not going to dethrone Golden State. You're going to have a hard time.
I wasn't going to do that anyway. You're not going to do that in the East. So it doesn't. You're not going to do that in the East.
Go to Philadelphia.
You're not going to dethrone Golden State, period. You're not going to dethrone Golden State.
I don't know. With those kids.
You need Kevin Durant to leave. If Kevin Durant leaves Golden State, then they will get dethroned. As long as Kevin Durant is there, they are not getting beat.
Okay, but with those two kids in Philadelphia who are becoming men, I got to tell you, you'd have a shot. I would give them a shot. If you get Embiid and Ben Simmons and LeBron, I would give them a shot against Golden State.
I would give them a shot, too.
You know? Right.
Why does everybody try to have determine LeBron's career? And I don't know why.
I'm not trying to determine. I'm just reacting.
No, I'm talking about that agent that says, I don't know why he would just want to come to L.A. and just make the playoffs. Who said that's what he's going to do?
Well, I do.
And who
I
said he
that.
Took nights off? First off, he's the best player in the world. Somebody coming at his neck every single night. The NBA game plans for LeBron James. There's no night off. So what is that agent talking about?
You know the Western Conference. You got to play him four times. You don't just have to play him twice.
But you still got teams that aren't that good in the Western Conference.
You
so I mean,
tell me, Phoenix isn't going to be better next year?
Phoenix is going to be better, but are they going to be good? Is it going to be like, oh man, we playing the Phoenix Suns? And I love the Phoenix Suns. I love what they're doing over there, and Ryan McDonough, everything that they got going on, James Jones, but. LeBron, I mean, I don't get how the fact that somebody could say that he's going to have a night off. There's no way he's going to have a night off.
You don't think Dallas is going to be better? All of a sudden.
So what does that mean?
Dirk coming back for year 20.
Start it.
What is that, Dirk coming back for? Year 21, 22? Really, Skip?
I'm not even thinking. I don't even count him.
Damn, I think that Boston was better than they were last year, right? And Cleveland kind of was worse than they were the year before. And what'd he do? Walked right into Boston, took care of them.
Game 7.
Took care of them.
Game 7, Skip.
Is Kyrie there?
It doesn't matter.
They beat, hold on.
Was Gordon Hayward there?
Did they beat Joel
Embiid? Kyrie wasn't there when they lost in the finals, and y'all killed LeBron for averaging damn near a triple-double in the finals.
LeBron got a
still
huge break last year because Boston took care of Philly.
Did Boston beat Philly?
Yes, they did. It was the upset of the playoffs.
Was Kyrie there?
And it saved LeBron. It saved LeBron from an early exit because Philly would have put him out of his misery.
I'm not sure about that.
Stop it. I'm not sure
about that. You know and I know. I'm going to say it again. LeBron is now chasing Michael B. Jordan. He's not chasing the Jordan. It's Michael B. Jordan that he's chasing in L.A. And he wants 1 year off from the pressure of trying to live up to Michael Jordan.
Think about it.
Because he can't. He's giving up the ghost.
Passing.
He had to give up the ghost, and it's okay.
Bye-bye.
It's okay.
He's never going to catch him with the 6-3.
He's 3-6 in the finals.
He's never going to catch him with that. He'll blow him out in all the statistical categories, but he'll never catch the 6-0. So that's over and done with. And can we stop comparing the two? They don't even play the same kind of game.
Stop comparing. He says he's better. I don't do it. He does it.
I've been stopped. Ain't nothing to talk about. I don't know why you keep bringing it up. Yeah. You interjected Michael Jordan and LeBron's discussion.
Oh, Eddie, who's better, Michael Jordan or LeBron? Tell us, please.
Michael Jordan is the best finisher, closer, killer. LeBron, overall basketball player, LeBron James.
Who would you rather have on your team?
Win. At the start of the game or the end?
To win. Just to win the game. Just to win the game, period.
One shot to win the game?
No,
just the
whole game.
Or to make the right
play?
I mean, see what I'm saying? To make the right play or to take the shot?
You're turning back into a lady.
No, I'm not. I'm trying to figure out what situation? To make the shot?
Just to win the game.
Or make the right play?
Just start the game. Who do you want, Michael Jordan or LeBron James? Give me Michael and I'll beat you every time. And you know it and I know it.
Man, why you put me on the spot like this? I love LeBron, but I got to go with Jordan.
Yeah, thank you. Game over, Shannon.
I gotta go with Jordan.
You lost again.
But we was just talking about him.
What?
We weren't talking about Jordan. We was just talking
that
about
what he always do.
King of what?
You set yourself up.
King of everything.
I know,
everything.
I did.
He's the GOAT of the NBA. He's the GOAT of the NBA.
So who do you think that on this list right here that I got that made the playoffs and then the three teams, Denver, the Clippers, and the Lakers outside the playoffs, who the Lakers can't beat on that list besides Golden State? I mean, Houston's going to be tough.
They're not better than the Trailblazers. The
get out of here.
Won 49
they
games
don't even want to be
three
there.
Seed. They're not better than the Thunder. They're not better. The Utah Jazz will just get better and better. That kid, Donovan Mitchell, he was the rookie of the year. You don't
Roy.
Think no, he wasn't.
Roy Simmons,
I'm sorry.
Rookie of the year.
Donovan
well,
Mitchell will get better and better and better. And they added Grayson Allen, who will help their rotation.
Well, I think he was the MVP last year. He could have been the MVP. Just like you think Donovan Mitchell could have been Rookie of the Year. I think LeBron could have been MVP last year.
New Orleans got better because Boogie didn't really fit with Anthony.
They lost Rondo.
Once they added Mirotic, they still got Drew Holiday.
Yeah, but Jrue Holiday was playing off the ball. Rondo was running the whole
show. Guess what? Julius Randle, who is another reason that I picked the Lakers to be the 8th seed last year, is now in New Orleans. They're going to be good. They're going to be better than the Lakers. They're just better.
Which team landed in
the run?
By the way, the Minnesota T-Wolves, you just raved about them all year. You had them as the, 7 or 6 seed, right?
Put some dew on that.
But I put
with me.
I put a swimming pool of dew.
I got the Lakers having a better record than the Jazz.
He
talking about the Jazz.
He said Lakers going to be the 8th spot.
You know what you better be careful of? Those Spurs are probably going to have a better Lakers.
I like DeMar DeRozan with the Spurs, though. I think it's going to be really good for his career.
LaMarcus Aldridge, Rudy Gay, Manu Ginobili's coming back, Patty Mills.
Manu Ginobili.
Manu with that sunroof.
He's a little long in the tooth.
Huh?
That's
a little long in the tooth.
Really?
He's a little long in the tooth.
He is. Boy, he won a bunch of games last year. You know what? The Spurs last year won 47 games with no Kawhi. Do you realize how great that was? So now they added DeMar DeRozan. At least it's better than having no Kawhi, right? They'll win more than the Lakers. They'll be a game better. The Lakers are going to be fighting for eight,
Well, if they're
seven.
A game better, they could be a game worse, too, if you're putting it that close.
And what about the Denver Nuggets who missed the playoffs? You don't think they're going to be better?
They missed the playoffs.
No, they'll be better like the Phoenix Suns. They'll be
Isaiah
better.
Thomas is going to help them. I thought he was really good down the stretch for the Lakers. He wasn't good in Cleveland.
I like the fact that LeBron don't have too much pressure coming in. It's the first season that he don't have the weight of the world on his back. And I think he's going to have a better, I think he's going to have a really good season with that.
That was my point.
He got a better.
He's got a honeymoon year.
We don't do honeymoon.
No, it's not.
I tell you what,
he's not going to take the year off.
I've seen people get divorced. I've seen people get divorced on their honeymoons. Act a fool and see what happens.
Yeah.
Rob Parker.
Well, that was the beginning of the end.
Exactly.
It didn't actually end in divorce.
It's not a good start.
Hey, why you put his business in the street?
Oh, my bad.
Like
you're right. I'm dry snitching on him.
Oh, Eddie, thank you for being here. I feel like we could keep talking about that one for a while. Coming up, Dak Prescott. Ezekiel Elliott had some interesting comments about the Cowboys' national anthem policy. We will talk about it next.